Hi students, today we are going to learn Form 2, Chapter 3, Nutrition. So previously we already stopped until vitamin, so today we want to learn about fiber. So basically, what is fiber? Fiber is a substance that cannot be broken down in the digestive system. Means after you eat, it is still there until the person poop out, the thing is still the same. Depend on what you eat, correct? Now, I think it's more like, let's say sunflower, the seed, or pomegranate. After, if you eat, then you poop, you can still see the pomegranate seed, or the kiwi seed, or the passion fruit seed, correct or not? After you eat, and then you poop, and then you can still see the, not the passion fruit seed, the dragon fruit seed, and you can still see the dragon fruit seed in the poop. Means, because the food, the thing cannot be digested in your body. Is this good or bad? Actually, this thing is good. Okay? Not telling you to eat the pencil, the metal that cannot be digested. Okay? But the things that you can eat and cannot be, that cannot be digested, we call this as fiber. It's good. Why? Because it cannot be broken down in the system. It's made up of the cellulose. It is good because it helps in the prevention of, let's see here, got a common constipation. You know, constipation means the person cannot poop. Usually, let's say when the person go to toilet and then he go there, and then the shit just won't come out. And sometimes, yeah. So why this thing happen? You might say the person didn't drink enough water, and the person didn't eat a lot of fiber, so he got this problem. And also, what we call it in Chinese, called jichong, something like that. Okay, it's a very common disease, like you cannot poop in the toilets, and then your anus there start to bleed, and this will cause a lot of problem. So remember, when you eat, you still need to eat a lot of fiber. So when you go to the toilet, it will come out very fast and it's healthy. When you look at the shit, you will feel this is a beautiful shit, not a bad looking shit, right? Because by looking at the shit, you know is how good how healthy are you. So this fiber is to stimulate the peristalsis. What does it mean? Peristalsis is here, the body contraction and relaxation of muscle along the esophagus. So when you eat, it will push the food go down. So nothing much here, just eat a lot of fiber so that to prevent constipation. What is constipation means? Bei pang sai, means you cannot poop, or you take very long time to poop, difficulty to poop, especially for children, right? Because children, they don't eat vegetables, so yep, you cannot poop. And okay, so what other things got fiber? Vegetable and fruit. Fruit, vegetable, and grain. Okay, eat a lot. It's very healthy. Minerals. Again, this is a very large chapter about mineral. Mineral is a non-organic substance required by body, but only need it very little. Here didn't say, but you need it in small quantities. So mineral is non-organic. Means that, for example, you can get salt from the sea. The sea is not a tree, right? The sea is not a fish. The sea is just like a sand with water. And by mixing the sand with water, you got the salt water. And the salt water, when you dry it up, and you got the salt. So actually, you are like eating the sand, correct or not? Then we call it mineral. It's non-organic. We can get salt from the sand. And not only for salt, there are a lot of mineral. And in case you don't know, a lot of the medicine that you eat, like Panadol, when you go to Speedmart, you want to buy, don't know, cough medicine or what. A lot of this medicine sometimes is, most of it, I would say, is not organic. And most of it is made up from petroleum, actually. Then you say, what? The medicine that I'm eating is actually from petroleum. You know petroleum or not? The thing that you use for the car, the petrol. Yes, your medicine usually is made from there. It's a non-organic compound. I don't know how they mix it, how they turn it, and do, then it become your medicine. Medicine is a very complicated subject. Okay, like one Panadol maybe come from 100 things or 1,000 things. You never know. It's their secret. They don't show it. They show it means they will got no money to earn. Okay, pharmaceutical company, they earn a lot of money by making medicine. So, back to here, minerals. So, let's see. Mineral, we have calcium, sodium, iron, iodine, phosphorus, potassium. And you can see here the mineral. The source is milk, prawn, green, vegetable. Okay, that's this. I would say this is the organic source, right? Because it is from vegetable, animal, is something. But when you go to pharmacy, what are the name of the pharmacy? Guardian, Watson, Alpha Pro, then you can buy the one bottle of calcium. So the one bottle of calcium, I don't know how they do. There is actually the bottle of calcium is they do not take from what rock or what sand. They mix it, process it, and then I put into the bottle and give you it, the pill. So I got no comment. It might be healthy, it might not be healthy, but usually I prefer organic things, okay? No need to go to Watson. Just eat like meal, prawn, green, vegetable. And in case the person really got problem, the doctor say need to eat, then maybe we only go. If you are healthy, I don't think you need to buy calcium pill. You can go to pharmacy, you buy calcium pill, sodium pill, iron pill, iodine pill, phosphorus pill, potassium pill. You can go Watson and buy all these things, but what is the point if you can eat from natural thing, which is more better, okay, seafood. So, yep, I still prefer the natural one, unless the person is sick, lah. Then it's a different person. Maybe he need more calcium. So, again, calcium, you know already that we get. Remember that bone only got you need calcium, not only calcium, you need vitamin D. Correct, not still remember or not, because vitamin D, if you don't have vitamin D, you got bone problem. Bone problem is racket. Just remember that. Again, racket. Racket. The badminton racket. Maybe you can imagine a badminton racket hit the person's leg and then the bone is broken. So remember racket, and followed by vitamin D and calcium. Okay, so this one you need to know. Or why calcium? Calcium is actually to build strong bone. But vitamin D, I see here got say or not, absorption of calcium. So you can see different function or not. You can eat calcium, but the body cannot absorb. So pangsai the calcium come out again. So what's the point? You want to eat and your body can absorb, seek 那个 vitamin. So you need two. You need calcium, you need vitamin D. Okay? So you need two. That's why it's like that. Okay? Calcium, recap. Sodium, salt, yen. If not enough of sodium, will cause chao gan, muscle cramp. So, of course, sometimes this one I feel weird lah, because if you ask this question, if it is asked by your PJ, right? Physical activity, PJK, they call it. Let's say the exam question asks, why Ali have muscle cramp, chao gan? Because Ali didn't do warm up. Then you will get correct. Because you didn't do warm up, ma. So you go to the field, you run, then you chao gan. But in science, why Ali got muscle cramp? Your answer is, Ali does not eat enough of salt. He does not have enough of salt. So he got chao gan. So you will get correct for science. But if you say in the science, because Ali didn't do warm up during the exercise, you get it wrong. Actually, both answers are correct. Depend on answer scheme. And hopefully you can understand. Because science, ma, science, you don't eat salt, then your muscle cramp. BJK, you don't exercise, you don't do warm up, then you muscle cramp. Both is correct, okay? Help to maintain nervous system. Iron, is to do blood. This one you remember. So anemia. If you, the name of not enough blood is anemia. So basically, you can see the face white color. If you see, you know, sometimes the face white color. Wow, why your face so white one? Because maybe the person don't have anemia, so he need to eat liver. You know, liver and the meat. So sometimes he might need to eat the chicken liver or the cow liver. It's so weird, right? People don't usually eat this thing, but sometimes it's healthy, okay? You still need to eat a bit of this. Okay, so it can build blood to prevent anemia. So this is iron. Then this iron means what? This iron is the, assuming this is iron. Eat this iron. Is this iron same with the iron in our table, my table, or my inside my pencil? Let's say here got iron. Is it the same? In some sense, if you want to talk about element, it's the same thing. That's why you don't eat a lot. That's why mineral say here, small quantity. You need iron. If I can take a big magnet, I put in front of you to pull out all the iron, actually, theoretically, I think it's possible, but I just need a very, very huge magnet to take out all the iron in your body. So, but we have very little, very, very little of iron. And again, I don't know how the medicine process. You can buy this in the Watson or what. I don't think they will take the iron from seafood or fruit. They will take from what stone, take from what thing, and then process it, and they give you the iron pill that you can buy in Watson or Guardian. Then you eat it. It is still healthy. Yeah? You eat Panadol, though it's made from rock, but it is still healthy. Okay, you still can eat it. And only in a small quantity, right? No people ask you to eat 12 Panadol in per day. Unless you want to go to the suicide, then you eat 12 Panadol, then can call 999. Iodine to prevent goiter. You know, goiter here very big. Okay? This thing here very big, sometimes you see. And then usually he didn't eat siham or lala seafood. Then you got this thing. I got a friend. Not to say bad thing about him, but he's a vegetarian. So one day, he got this disease called goiter. So he's so young because I'm still young. I'm 34 years old, but looks like 18. So he got a goiter for a young age, like 13 years old. So I don't know lah, because he's vegetarian, but you need to eat lala siham, I don't know. So I don't know lah, now he's healed already. So please eat a bit, don't eat too much sotong lah. A bit of lala, a bit of siham, then it's good, okay? So you can prevent your goiter, can have a beautiful neck. Phosphorus, just now I forget. For the strong bone, you need three things. We already learned, remember this. Calcium, you need vitamin D for absorption, and you also need phosphorus. Again, it's mineral, so you don't need to take so much, but you still need to take it, okay? To strengthen the bone and teeth to form nucleic acid, DNA, and RNA. So again, the same, so you will have recap bone problem. So when the question asks, not enough phosphorus, recap. Not enough of vitamin D, recap. Not enough of calcium, recap. You don't say bone weak, then you get answer wrong, okay? You just answer according to the term lah. They just want you to ask recap, then you say recap lah. You don't say other thing. Potassium in a plant and animal to help muscle contraction and so on. Again, if not, you will have paralysis and muscle cramp. So many things to remember. What you want to remember? I will just try to think, so that at least you remember this thing lah. If let's say you cannot remember all, this one you need to know the mineral. This one I think is lesser lah. Potassium I think seldom ask. This one you need to know. The other one this one usually sometimes can tembak, right? You can know you can tembak. They seldom ask, but usually student tembak this one they will get correct. I mean you just have some. I mean, you read and then you agak-agak, you usually can answer the question. So yeah, this one you need to remember. And for this one also it's the same thing. This one you need to know. And this one, night blindness, beriberi, scurvy, rickets, celerity, maintain night vision, this one, okay? This one you need to know. Usually exam they will ask this thing. This thing usually the source of food you usually tembak, agak-agak, usually you can get correct, okay? You make sure you memorize this first, then this, only you start to memorize all the thing here, okay? The keyword, just memorize the keyword. No need to memorize the whole sentence, okay? This is where the student do wrong, okay? Highlight everything, remember word by word. That is not how we want to do revision, okay? Water, very fast. Water, what are the elements in water? Hydrogen and oxygen, correct or not? If I want to write out the formula for water, it will be H2O, correct or not? So when you go to buy drink, you don't say, I want water, I want sky juice, plain juice, I want H2O, give me a cup of H2O. Okay, so it's the chemical formula for water. For what are the functions of water? As a chemical solvent, as transportation medium. But of course, our transportation is our blood, correct or not? Our blood helps to transport the oxygen, the mineral, the vitamin, the everything. All the LRT in your body is the blood. And the blood made out of what? Made of iron. Correct or not? Still remember or not? Then iron build hemoglobin, red blood cell. And the blood is made out of water. That's why you say water, ma. Water, then your blood carry, then it transport, then everything just makes sense. Correct or not? So you need to drink at least 2 liters of water a day. Yes, please drink a lot of water. So Alan Kebab might ask, if the person doesn't drink water, what will happen to him? He will get dehydrated. Long term, and after a while, if you don't have enough water, you might have kidney problem. That's why when you have kidney problem, kidney cancer, because the person seldom drink water. He seldom drink water, he like to eat the sweet orange juice, he like to eat the teh tarik outside, every time drink Pepsi, teh tarik. Then you don't want to drink water. So basically the body cannot filter the thing properly, but due to lack of water, the kidney need to work very hard. Okay, so at last you will have the kidney problem. So don't eat too much of Pepsi, Coca-Cola, teh tarik. But if you do drink more water so that it can dilute it, the sugar. So it's better lah. That's why when I go out, if you want to enjoy teh tarik or coffee, usually you just ask a teh tarik, 1 cup and another plain water. So you can enjoy the teh tarik and drink the water. Because you drink sugar, you feel very thirsty, right? The more you already eat chili, you feel thirsty, you ask teh tarik. But the teh tarik very sweet. So after you drink finish, you also feel thirsty, you ask one more teh tarik and one more teh tarik, okay? Then just take some water. I think Chinese tea is very good, okay? Chinese tea, because due to lack of sugar and it's plain, so I think it's good for your kidney. Okay, so we finish until here. The question might ask, how you know question, they like to ask you how to test. So you need to learn to test starch, glucose, protein, and fat, okay? You need to learn to test all these 4 things. So let's look at the first test. For starch, it's very easy. You don't need to read all these things, just make it simple. To test starch, you put iodine. Just put iodine. Iodine you can buy from Watson, Guardian, or Alpha Pro, or all the pharmacy company. And iodine is the huang yao shui. Okay, you just put in, turn blue black. It will turn blue black. So I just put the observation you need to know. So I will just put in here blue black. So if you want to test starch, the question asks, how you want to test starch? Okay, put in the iodine solution, the solution will turn blue black. You can do this at your home, take your huang yao shui, iodine, take some rice, put in your plate, and then you put in the yellow color medicine. Then you find out that actually your rice will turn blue black. You can try this at home, okay? How to, let's say the question asks how to test glucose. So your answer will be use Benedict test. So Benedict test is like this, okay? Put in the glucose. So how do you go to SpeedMart? You buy the glucose, sugar lah, glucose. Put some water, mix it, the water. Put in the Benedict solution. You cannot buy Benedict solution in pharmacy lah. And it will turn brick red precipitate. So the observation is brick red precipitate. So when you put in, the Benedict is blue color. After you put in blue color, it will become red color. So it become like precipitate is like a jelly thing. So it become like jelly red color, showing that there is glucose. How about myelin? Myelin is to test protein. The same thing, you put in myelin inside, albumin is the egg. You know the egg, because egg got a lot of protein mah. You want to have a lot of protein, the easiest way is, and the cheaper way is to eat egg. That's why the bodybuilder, some of them will take like 5 or 10 eggs per day. So, you just take the albumin from the egg, and then you put in the myelin test, and what you will observe. So, if there are protein, so you will use myelin test, and after you test it, you will have a reddish brown precipitate. So, yep, it's red and brown precipitate. It's quite easy, right? Because here is brick red precipitate, and this one is reddish brown. I mean, it's still red, okay? Just different color of red. Alcohol, you can use emulsion test. So, if you use emulsion test, what will happen? Okay, so let me do some advertisement. I don't earn any money from revision book. So I recommend students, sometimes this question, right, you need to use revision to book to rule because you cannot. And you are just form 2 or form 1, form 2, you buy this book, it's very good because this book is form 1, form 2, form 3. Go and buy something like this. And you can use it for your PT3. The earlier you buy is better because when you go to form 3, you buy then it's wasted because form 1, form 2, you didn't buy. So now it's still February. Go to online buy. I think online you can get a cheaper price. Sasbadi, Pelangi, or whatever. Go and buy. Textbook is good because actually in exam, the question they can ask only from your textbook. So textbook is the main syllabus that you guys can learn because they cannot ask something that is not in the textbook. But this book will be 95% of your textbook. Then you say, why I want to read this one 95% when the textbook got 100%. Yes, but this thing is more systematic because when you read like this, you got diagram. So when you read, you feel more comfortable and like you can answer when teacher asks you question or what. So please go and buy one book. Just one book enough for me. Okay, Pelangi, Sasbadi, Oxford or whatever you can buy. Of course, textbook is also good. You can use that textbook. Okay, so for emulsion and test, what are the observation? So what are the observation? So emulsion is formed. Actually, it's the more like a white color emulsion. Okay, you can see this one is like they put the oil and you can see the emulsion is formed. Oil and then you put in alcohol, it will mix. Okay, so you can see a white color showing that there is a fat. Of course, you can use your body oil or the chicken or whatever oil that you want to use to test whether the thing is got fats or not. Ethanol is flammable, yes, so put it away from fire. Ethanol is one type of alcohol, correct or not? Alcohol got a lot of name. Methanol, ethanol, protanol, butanol, pentanol, hexanol, heptanol, octanol, and a lot of the name. So it's very flammable, so be careful, especially for girl. That's why when you go in the science lab, they ask what the girl must tie your hair, if not later you burn your hair, okay, in the experiment lab. Activity observation. So I already give you guys all the answer, right? So this one you need to know, not for the sake of writing down the answer, but you need to know, okay? Observation, blue black, you don't write blue black, okay? You just say blue black solution is formed, okay? For Benedict, okay, brick red precipitate is form. If you don't know, say it's form, you say come out or whatever, like, I think you still get correct, but it's form, lah, huh? Or it's made, or if your English not good, you just say come out, lah, huh? The thing come out. Reddish brown precipitate will be form. At least a sentence, okay? A sentence. Emulsion is form. So you just write it at here. Question. Why is the heating of Benedict is test and Milan test is carried out in water bath? Why? So for number 1A, the question, why we need to heat during the Benedict test? Okay, so when glucose and Benedict solution is mixed, when you heat it, the solution will change color because copper ion is being reduced. Benedict solution is made up of copper sulfate, means it's blue color, and the atom is copper sulfate, Cu. And when you heat it, copper ion is being reduced to copper 2 ion become copper 1 ion. So then there's a reaction that you can see which it will change color. If you don't want to heat, then nothing will happen because there's no reaction, no ion is being reduced. So I think the simple answer to this question is why we need to heat, so that the color change can be observed. Okay, that will be the first question. And the second question, why Milan test is carried out in water bath? So let's see the experiment. Okay, for this question, why is it need to be carried out in water bath? Means that here you just take fire and burn, or Benedict, here you just burn heating, or in a water bath. And here also you use a water bath. I mean, you can put here, the thing here, straight away put the fire. Right or not? You just put the fire, and then the thing will be keep on burning. But you cannot do that. You want to put a water. So why you want to put a water? So that if you just straight away heat it, the thing will spill out. Okay, because you burn it, it's too hot, it spill out. So actually it's to spread the heat, okay? So, and to slow down the heating of the process. Correct or not? So I would say, okay, so to spread the heating so that the heat can spread, okay? Instead of burning it, we want to spread it to slow down the fire. And so that the thing won't spill, means this thing won't come out lah. You put fire, means this thing, sometimes it will spill out, okay? This thing will come out, like that, come out, okay? Tao diao. So we don't want that, so we put the water bath to slow down the heat. I think I read the question wrongly. Why is it heating Benedict and Milan is telling us water bath? So basically, the wonder I think this is very so difficult, like from 4 questions. So this one just ignore. The answer for 1A is to spread the heating process below the test tube so the content will not spill. So that's it for this video, and I will continue this question during the next video. Thank you and bye bye.